In 2010 het 50-50 die story uitgesaai van 'n paar witkruisarende wat reg langs een van die besigste snelweë in Johannesburg nes gebou het. Maar wat hierdie situasie so uniek en besonders gemaak het, is die feit dat hierdie arende hulle nes reg bo op 'n elektriese kragpaal gebou het. In 2008 ongelukkig het onbekende kwaadoeners hierdie nes totaal en al verwoes. Maar gelukkig was 'n konstruksiemaatskappy gedurende daardie tydperk besig met die opgradering van die snelweg en het tot die redding van hierdie arende gekom en vir 'n tipe van 'n kunsmatige platform nes op Meyersplaas in die Kliprivierberg omgewing gebou. Dit het die voëls nie te lank geneem om tuis te raak in hulle nuwe huis nie. Ongelukkig het hulle eerste poging om 'n kuiken groot te maak op die kunsmatige nesplatform misluk. Hierna het die volgroeide paar die nes verlaat. Vroeg in April 2010 het die arende egter teruggekeer en hierdie keer was hulle broeipoging suksesvol. Die jong witkruisarend wat Hansa genoem is, is deur ons verfilm tydens een van sy eerste vlugte. Ons kamera het in Augustus 2010 die arende die laaste keer op film vasgelê.
Die jongetjie wat ons genoem het Hansa, sy het gevlieg omtrent 16 Augustus. Toe sy gevlieg het, omtrent 'n maand later, toe is die mannetjie weg, spoorloos verdwyn. Toe moes die wyfie alleenig kos kry vir die jong arend wat baie moeilik was. Op 9 Julie vanjaar het die wyfie 'n nuwe mannetjie gekry en hom teruggebring hierso na die kunsmatige nesplatform.
Dit is ongelooflik dat die witkruisarende so goed by hulle nuwe tuiste aangepas het. Alles het goed verloop vir die Kliprivierberg arende, wel in elk geval tot Woensdag, 7 November van jaar.
Yeah, I just came from work, coming down the road from that area there, coming through the bushes, because I live just opposite the flats there. And as I came down, I normally see the local guys hanging around in the area over here. And I was always keen to see them, how's it, how you doing, you know, that kind of thingy. So then I see them sort of holding and hitting down, sort of, well, I thought it was a dog, to be honest with you, because it was quite a big looking creature. And it's getting sort of dark. So, you know, I asked him, what are you guys doing? And they can know we're going to eat that. And I started laughing. Until I see the guy hitting it again, then I got a bit angry. And I reckon, stop it now, because now you're like offending me because you're hurting that, whatever it is. Then they showed me the little pot of boiling water they had in the 25 liter. I reckon, it's going in there. I reckon, no ways.
So when you actually saw the bird, did you realize it's a black eagle?
No, I'm going to tell you no, I never believed it.
How did you persuade them to give you the bird?
Well, I knew a couple of the guys over there that always hangs around in the area. Plus the fact that I took out 30 rand and gave them, all the guys wanted was just something to eat.
Daar's net een rede waarom 'n volgroeide paar witkruisarende in hierdie omgewing 'n ander arend in hulle gebied sou toelaat. Dit moes een van die kuikens wees wat een van die vorige seisoene uitgebroei het. Ons het ons sommetjies gemaak en tot die gevolgtrekking gekom dat hierdie arend Hansa moet wees.
Die feit dat die arend nog in die omgewing is, dis maar 7,5 km van die nes af. Ek dink dit is die enigste rede wat my sê dat dit nog steeds Hansa is wat in die omgewing is en dat haar ouers haar toelaat om maar hier te wees, want daar is geen broeidruk op die oomblik nie.
Roland se vinnige optrede het ongetwyfeld Hansa se lewe gered. Hy het kontak gemaak met Lona Stanton van die Battelier Raptor Rescue Sentrum in Johannesburg.
So, what are the extent of his injuries?
If you look at him carefully, you'll see that he's got a very, very scruffy tail, and the edge of his flight feathers are also quite ruffled, and it's just from being roughly handled, because they obviously caught him and then they had to make a fire to cook him, and while the fire was being made, they subdued him. That's why his feathers are looking so bad, but otherwise he looks fine. And all I'm worried about is that he's flown into the power lines and that he's suffering a bit from electrocution, and that unfortunately takes about a week to show up, so I won't know for a while. But he's eating and he's behaving absolutely normally, so I'm hoping that we can let him go in a few days' time.
We've been talking about him and he is gonna fly again, but we don't really know the sex of the bird. Is it possible to sex him or her?
Bird of prey experts, in inverted commas, argue about this all the time. And in my opinion, it's a male, because it's a lot smaller than many of the females that I've had in.
How often do you get birds that come here that were saved from the pot?
Seldom. They normally on the side of the road being sold, to passers-by. But we have a, I don't think we've had many that were on the brink of being cooked. We like this chap.
So Ronan is actually the hero in the story.
Oh, absolutely.
I'm going to make definitely plans to be there when it's released. You know, that'll be for me personally, this thing, the highest point in my life. Just to see the bird take off and see how it looks. So I have an image in my head. So next time when I'm walking or driving, I say, you know what, I think I rescued that bird.
Roland se wens was op die punt om waar te word. Hansa is een van die min roofvoëls wat heel waarskynlik 'n botsing met 'n kragdraad oorleef het en net uit die pot ontsnap het. Hy het 'n redder nodig gehad en Roland het gereageer. Weereens net te bewys dat 'n gewone burger soos Roland 'n groot verskil kan maak wanneer dit kom by die beskerming van ons stedelike roofvoëls.
Bou, jy stap al so lank pad saam met hierdie ouetjie en vandag word hy vrygelaat te danke aan Roland. Is daar iets wat jy van wil sê?
As 'n blyk van waardasie, wil ek net namens die projek hierdie sertifikaat aan jou oorhandig.
Thanks a million. This is really awesome.
Mense soos jy is nie baie nie.
Luna, let's do it. Nou ja, ek dink dit is tyd om die gelukkige arend vry te laat.
Oh, that's beautiful, isn't it?
Once again free.
Yeah.
Like an eagle should be,
really. Perfectly.
Well done.